Biocompatibles is a medical device company with a specialism in oncology. We're talking now to its chief executive, Crispin Simon. It's good to talk to you. It's a very interesting company. Interesting for a number of reasons, not least of which is the fact you're making a profit and you're paying a dividend. Explain your business model.
Well, we've now got to more than £30 million worth of sales. We have very attractive gross margins, and that's how you get to profitability. The business model divides itself into two. We have our own range of proprietary products, which are medical devices for use in cancer, and that's our main thing. But investors also like to see the endorsement of other big companies, so we have a licensing activity, and our scientists are often coming up with new good ideas, and if we can't afford to develop them ourselves, then we'll license them. And we have two important relationships, one with AstraZeneca and one with Medtronic. So it's a bit of both.
But my understanding is that the main trunk of the business is with its oncology business and these drug-eluting beads, is that correct?
Yes, that's right.
Explain how they work.
So the drug-eluting beads were designed in the first place to address the fact that chemotherapy, which is obviously one of the main standards of cancer treatment, is extremely toxic. The patients tolerate it very, very poorly. The other mainstays of cancer treatment are surgery and radiotherapy, and then of course chemotherapy. And we'd like to make ourselves a fourth, which is to take our drug-eluting beads and deliver them very close to the tumour so that the chemo can be delivered both very locally for a maximum tumour kill and a lower systemic availability, i.e. less likely to give the patient side effects, and also a very delayed release as well. So it releases over 14 days. And that combination, we believe, can open up this fourth avenue of cancer treatment. It'll take a while. But we've made a good start.
What sort of cancers are we talking about here? I think we're talking mainly about liver cancer, aren't we? But the cancers come into the liver from other parts of the body, don't they?
That's right. So we started, and our main usage is in primary liver cancer. That is when the tumour first occurs in the liver. And then the second stage of our strategy is to address cancers where there's another primary, and that then metastasizes into the liver. So the other primary might...
Metastasizing is what? Moving in?
Thank you.
Right.
Yes. The cells have broken off from the primary and they've traveled into the liver. So the original primary, be it breast or lung or prostate or colorectal, might have been treated many years before, but there were micrometastases, perhaps not evident, certainly not symptomatic, that will be appearing in the liver over a period of time, and it's those tumours that our drug-eluting beads are directed at, so both the primary liver cancer and now increasingly metastatic disease in the liver.
Whereabouts is growth going to come from for the company? Is it just by laying out more of this business?
Well, what's often not very well known is that those four sites are the most common sites of the primary tumour. They may be well known as the four primary sites. What's less well known is that the main cause of death of a cancer patient is liver failure as a result of the replacement of functioning liver by tumour, which obviously has no functioning liver activity. So patients will often die of liver failure. Now, they were identified on the autopsy as having died of liver failure associated with breast cancer, but in fact it was the liver failure that caused them to die. So we estimate that while at the moment around 20,000 patients per annum are treated with our therapy.
Globally?
Globally. Mm-hmm. So we're approved in most of the countries in the world, with the exception of some countries in Asia. Our products are used globally in more than 40 countries in what we'd estimate to be around 20,000 procedures per annum. That's a lot of, in about 500 to 1,000 hospitals around the world. But if you add in all that potential metastatic disease, as we accumulate more clinical data over time, we think the market potential is up to 1 million patients per annum, so 50 times where we are now. Now, that'll take time, but we're on the right track.
At the moment, your share price doesn't seem to anticipate that sort of potential. We're talking about 270 pence a share at the moment, but Piper Jaffray estimates it could be up to 410 pence a share as a more realistic valuation if you look out from this point for the company. Do you agree with that sort of valuation?
Well, I think that the investment analysts have recognised over the last couple of years, and more analysts now cover our stock than they did a year or 2 years ago, that the company is now developing some real momentum, both with respect to our financial performance, which is important, but also our reputation amongst clinicians. And as a result, they have price targets above the current price. But we'd like to think that if we can get to the current price target, then they'll raise the price target again.
I know you're monitoring acquisition opportunities, and you have undertaken acquisitions where you've managed to achieve an increase in sales force, for example, rather than geographical territory. But what about the future for the company and how its expansion is going to be formed? You're going to go to China. I mean, India's got enormous growth at the moment. Are those markets you could be looking at?
Yes. We've recently launched the product in Brazil and Argentina and in Korea and Taiwan. We've extended our relationship with a large Japanese pharmaceutical company that covers Japan and India. So we absolutely intend to have global coverage. And wherever the product is used, in whatever territory, the doctors say, yes, this has got a better side effect profile. The patients appear to tolerate it well. It's very rare that a doctor will use our product and then say, well, actually, we'll go back to what we did before. We have a very high rate of sustaining conversions.
Okay, all right, to Crispin Simon, thanks for joining us, the chief executive there of Biocompatibles.